Hello students, how are you all? As we did verbs, we have already begun this chapter. So we will continue this verse. First of all, we will just do the recapitulation. Like verbs are the words that shows action, or action showing words are known as verbs. Okay, there are certain types of verbs we can say, like what a person does, what is done to a person, the state in which a person or thing is, and what a person is, and then what a person or thing has. Okay, these things we show from the words like that we call verbs, and these are numbers, like number of words in verb may vary 1 to 4, like 1, and Avina plays hockey, is playing, has been playing, might have been playing. In each sentence the number is increasing and it increase up to 4 mainly. Then we learnt about the kinds of verb, main and auxiliaries. Main verbs are the sentences, and auxiliaries we come to know that we called auxiliaries helping verbs. There are three types mainly: primary, modal auxiliaries, and semi auxiliaries. Now we will move to the next topic, which is the object of a verb. What is the object of a verb? The object of a verb is the person or thing that receives the action expressed by the verb. What? The object of a verb is a person or thing that receives the action expressed by the verb. Means the action that is expressed or the showing by the verb is received by the object. How? The action begins with the subject. Okay? Then doer and passes over to the object. How? Now we will understand this. The object answers the question formed by verb plus what or verb plus whom. Like Parth loves chocolates. Who is the subject? Parth. What is the verb? Loves. So what is the action passes over to? Like Parth loves what? Chocolates. Loves what? Chocolate. Okay, so chocolate is the object of the verb loves. Chocolates is the object of the verb loves. Parth loves me. Loves whom? Me. Me is the object of the verb loves. Now come to direct object and indirect object. Direct object, indirect object, we will discuss about this. Direct object is the person or thing that directly receives the action expressed in the verb. Direct object is the person or thing that directly receives the action expressed by the verb. Direct object usually answers the question formed by the verb plus what. How? Carry the baby on your shoulders. Carry what? Carry what? Carry the baby. Uma Devi teaches Kathak. Teaches what? Kathak. Indirect object is a person or thing that receives the direct object. Indirect object is a person or thing that receives the direct object. He gave me a camera. Gave what? A camera. Indirect person is the person that thing or thing that receives the direct object. Means, you come to know that direct object is something that the action done by subject is expressed by direct object. An indirect object is the person or thing that receive direct object. See, this is 1, 2, 3 step. Subject, whatever subject is doing, is expressing through direct, and after whatever direct verb or direct object is there, that is expressed by the indirect. It receives direct object. Like camera is the direct object. He gave me a camera. Who has given a camera? Me. And me is direct object here, so camera is indirect. Okay, now coming to the next part, that is intransitive and intransitive verbs. First of all, just direct and indirect object is quite clear to you. Uma Devi teaches Kathak. Teaches what? Kathak is direct object. ही गेव मी अ कैमरा. सो मी इज डायरेक्ट एंड कैमरा इज इनडायरेक्ट हेयर. ओके, हेयर ट्रांजिटिव एंड इनट्रांजिटिव वर्ब्स. ट्रांजिटिव एंड इनट्रांजिटिव वर्ब्स. अ वर्ब नीड्स एन ऑब्जेक्ट टू मेक कंप्लीट सेंस इज कॉल्ड अ ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब. A verb that needs an object to make the complete sense is called transitive verb. Like bachung kicked. Bachung kicked. Bachung kicked the ball. Object needed to complete a sentence. Like I cooked. I cooked dosa. So dosa is the object. Child sleep. Child sleeps. And child sleeps on the bed. So bed is the object here. And we will call it transitive sentence. Chief Minister inaugurated. No sense. Chief Minister inaugurated. The chief minister inaugurated the trade fair. Object needed to complete the sense. Okay, so when an object needs to make complete sense of the sentence is called transitive verb. And intransitive verbs make complete sense by itself. It does not take an object. In intransitive verb, we don't need an object, because it complete the meaning or the sense of the sentence. But in transitive verb, we need an object to make the complete sense of the sentence. In intransitive verb, like the baby was smiling, the soldiers walked briskly. Here the sentence is completed, means as it is giving the complete sense. Was smiling and walked are in transitive verbs here. Okay. If I am saying the child sleeps on the bed. Okay. Now if I am saying the child sleeps soundly. Are you getting me? The child sleeps soundly is intransitive verb. And the child sleeps on the bed is transitive. A verb that makes complete sense by itself is called an intransitive verb. Here is some note. A large number of verbs can be used both as intransitive and as transitive. How? The driver stopped the car, transitive. The car stopped, intransitive. Okay. The maid broke the jug, transitive. The jug broke, intransitive. See, the same sentence has been given in the transitive and intransitive to show transitive and intransitive. Therefore, instead of saying whether a verb is transitive or intransitive, we prefer whether a verb is used transitively or intransitively. Okay, means use. You have to check the use of verb, how it is used in the sentence. Clear? Now moving to the next one. Here we will come on the finite and non-finite verbs. A finite verb is a verb that has tense. Besides, it has to agree with its subject in person and number, so its form changes accordingly. What is a finite verb? A finite verb is a verb that has tense. Keep this in mind. Beside, it has to agree with its subject, means having tense, this is must, that this should agree with the subject in person and number. Now just keep in mind subject verb agreement. When the subject is singular, the verb will be singular in form, and when the subject is plural, then verb be plural in form. So keep that in mind, that it has to agree with its subject in person and number, so its form changes accordingly. Like ही इज सिंगिंग, ही इज, करेक्ट. सब्जेक्ट वर्ब अग्रीमेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू पर्सन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट. आई एम सिंगिंग, इफ आई एम सिंग आई इज सिंगिंग एंड ही एम सिंगिंग, देन दिस इज टोटली रॉन्ग बिकॉज देयर इज नो सब्जेक्ट अग्रीमेंट. ही सिंग्स एंड दे सिंग. हियर अगेन यू कैन सी दैट व्हेन द सब्जेक्ट इज सिंगुलर देन द वर्ब इज सिंगुलर, एंड व्हेन द सब्जेक्ट इज प्लूरल देन वर्ब फॉर्म इज प्लूरल ऑल्सो. सो फाइनाइट वर्ब इज अ वर्ब दैट हैज टेंस. नाउ moving to the non-finite, a non-finite verb retains the same form whatever be the subject. It will retain the same form whatever the subject is, no matter. He loves to sing, I love to sing, they love to sing. It will be in the same form, and you will also add to here. Note, a sentence must have a finite verb in it, but non-finite verbs are not necessary. A non-finite verb is used to expand the meaning of a sentence. A sentence must have a finite verb in it, but non-finite verbs are not necessary. Means, it should have a finite verb. Means, there is a rule that it is must frame a sentence, that a sentence should have a finite verb. A non-finite verb is used to expand the meaning of a sentence. When you want to expand it more, when you want to expand it to make the sense clear, then you will use a non-finite. Like I love to sing. What I love to sing. So this is expanding. There are three kinds of non-finite verbs. There are three kinds of non-finite verbs. What are they? They are infinite, to form, to work, to play. Infinite, to form, to work, to play. And gerund, ing form, working, playing. See, ing form, but it is used as gerund and it used as noun. Gerund is used as noun as subject in the sentence, like swimming is a good exercise. Okay. Then coming to the next participle, ing form, working and playing. Keep that in mind, both the gerund and the participle have the same form. Working, working, playing, playing, but here infinite. Okay, infinitive, it is to work, to play. Got it? Then coming to the next one, that is the formation of the verbs. Formation of the verb, how the verb forms. So, we will move to the next video. We will begin this formation of verbs, but here you learnt about the finite and non-finite verbs. Okay, now finite verb is that is a verb that has tense, and non-finite verbs retains the same from whatever be the subject. It expand the meaning. Clear? You have learned that there are three kinds of non-finite verbs: infinitive, infinitive, gerund, and participle. To work, to play, working, playing, participle, working and playing. And keep in mind that gerund and participle are the same form. Thank you and have a nice day. Resume to the next video.